So the first day, we just decided to go south on the one as far as we could go. I forget if it was last year or the year before, Big Sur had a major washout, and so the road just isn't there anymore, so we wanted to see. I could not stop being really concerned about the pampas grass. Isn't that invasive? It was everywhere. So I spent a lot of time pointing out and commenting about the pampas grass. But here it is. This is as far down south as you could go, Big Sur. We came, we saw, we turned it around. The last time I had been in Big Sur was a very long time ago with one of my best friends, college roommates from Stanford, and she took me camping to Pfeiffer, I think. And we saw this band that night that we stayed. Oh, hey, hold on a second. I'll come back to that. So my old eyes are failing me. Even zoomed in, I couldn't tell if these were like pieces of driftwood or if they were seals or what the heck. But I think I probably have that one phobia where if you see a lot of something, it grosses you out. Freaks you out. Like one butterfly is cool, but if you see like 1,000 of them, you freak out. And this was grossing me out. They looked like leeches. And so Arturo and I are arguing if they are real things or not. Anyway, I heard, oh no, trip is complete without a little plant poaching. So I was being reprimanded for taking a plant sample. Look at all that pampas grass. You see what I mean? I don't think that's native. Anyway, I saw this band. This had been like going on 20 years ago. And it was just at this random campground bar in Big Sur. They were so hauntingly beautiful. They were called the Mermen. It was this new surf guitar. And so I was talking about the Mermen this whole day. I was also talking about Big Little Lies. I think that's what it's called. The best show I've ever seen. Look, we saw a porn free in the wild, and Arturo was so embarrassed because I pulled over to ask them about their porn free. Look, there's those things again. There's so many of them. The heck are they? Beautiful or gross? You tell me what you think. Oh, that was the most hiking we did. We went to this, hiked up to this bar restaurant called Naptha or Neptune or Napalm or something. It was beautiful. And we did go on a walk. We did go on a coastal walk on some of the trails that day. About invasive species. It didn't say anything about pampas grass. So maybe I'd be tripping, I don't know. A couple of things about Carmel. Pretty bougie. I was just on high alert for Clint Eastwood. He used to be the mayor, and he owns a couple of establishments there. In very rapid succession, you're going to see couple images from Tiffany and company. We went inside. I felt like we were being watched and followed, like we're gonna steal something. The stuff there just doesn't even look real. But I was telling Arturo about the Truman Capote story, movie, he'd never seen him. So he's got some work to do, I guess. And then you're going to see a bunch of pictures of bathrooms, because nobody in Carmel has a bathroom inside their own place. You have to, like, it's a schlep. You have to, like, walk out and hike out somewhere down a corridor and alley to use a restroom all over the town. Except for, oh, watch this. Here comes a Frank Lloyd Wright. And there it is. All right, now we're in Tiffany's. So then we find this little dive bar, and they knew the Mermen. They played the Mermen for me. We had a great little conversation about Bill Murray and overpriced whiskey. And this place, this shitty little bar of all places, it's the only place in town that had its own restroom. And look at it. It's a great restroom. Best restroom of the trip. This was a very expensive restaurant's restroom that you had to hike to. But here's the restaurant. It was, I forget the name of the chef. Everything was great. It was really great food, delicious. It was just like way overpriced. It was fine, but like it didn't, you know, it was like a $50 baked potato. And you're like, it's a really good baked potato, but it was just a baked potato. Anyway, then we stumble into this art gallery. They had a very interesting artist there. They had a couple of different artists. This guy was more pop art. He was more my speed. And then this one painting caught my eye because it's this girl. My great uncle Alan had this painting called The Nightmare in his bedroom. And it was a picture of a girl just like this. And she was tumbling like 4 or 5 times repeated on the same canvas. Like she's having a nightmare. So anyway, and then I found this Miss Pac-Man. I thought she was so beautiful. She was so glittery. And I was talking about how cool it would be to give to Omar the Garage 79. And then the gal there, of course, she's a real estate agent and an art salesman. She shows me it's 25 grand. And she really, really thought she got a live one. She tried very hard for quite a while to, not even in a pushy way, just in a very competent salesperson way, convince our drunk asses to buy $25,000 worth of art. So sorry. We love you, Omar, but love you that much. This is more my speed. Coach, short for stagecoach. This thing was like 99% off, and I bought it